Today, I'll ground you in the core things to know about when deploying and managing Microsoft 365 powered devices. So what is a Microsoft 365 powered device? Well, it's one that brings together Windows 10, Office 365 Pro Plus, and the Enterprise Mobility Plus Security Suite. Plus, integrated cloud-driven experiences to boost teamwork and creativity with the latest security tech, all in a way that's simple to manage. Over the next few minutes, I'm going to take you through the IT aspects of planning, building, deploying, and operating the technologies that comprise Microsoft 365 powered devices. Now, there are a few things that make the connected modern stack different from maybe your last major deployment. At the core of Microsoft 365 is its Identity and Access Management service, Azure Active Directory. As you might expect, that enables the sign-in experience that drives things like Azure AD Join and secure connectivity to cloud and productivity resources. It also enables new options for device and configuration management without requiring connectivity to your local network. For Windows 10, in-place upgrade is the recommended approach instead of wipe and reload reimaging processes that you might be using today. This preserves apps, data, and configurations from the previous install. Now, if you haven't switched from BIOS to UEFI, now's the time. UEFI not only speeds up boot times, but it's also required to enable many of the modern security capabilities in Windows 10. And there are tools available now to make that switch after or during upgrades to Windows 10. For Office 365 Pro Plus desktop apps, there are new installation options that are different to the MSI-based packages of the past. But don't worry, it's still a local copy of Office, and you can use your deployment tools to provision and configure apps. Speaking of device management tools, Microsoft Intune can be used to manage your Windows 10 devices like other mobile devices all from one place. And you can also co-manage Windows 10 devices with System Center Configuration Manager and Microsoft Intune. Finally, we've introduced a new process to deploy Microsoft 365 powered devices called the Windows Autopilot Deployment Service. This lets you work with your hardware providers to configure your devices so that the moment they connect to the internet, from any location during the Windows 10 initial setup, you can begin customizing the device and experience. So I've covered the things to know when you're planning the deployment of your Microsoft 365 powered devices. Now, let's talk about how to get started. The good news here is that there are some new tools that you can use to plan what you need to do to assess your endpoints. The first step is really to look at your current approach for desktop and device management, then figure out which new capabilities you want to move to and how. The IT roadmap for Microsoft 365 planning tool is a great starting point that you can use to assess and plan for core identity and access management services, plus device management updates at a high level. This also arms you with a roadmap action plan that you can send to your stakeholders. Once you have a broad plan in place, you can focus on assessing your current devices. And for that, we've built new tools with Windows Analytics Upgrade Readiness to help identify devices, OS versions, apps, drivers, and more to assess those against compatibility information to help target your initial deployments. You can also assess upgrade readiness for Office using the same tools. And as you plan your rollout, we recommend that you follow the concept of deployment rings. This is where insiders typically represent around 1% of your organization. Maybe that's the IT team or other users you've identified. They get the updates first, then you can start to broaden the scope and broaden the rollout and deployment over time. So that was the planning phase. Now let's move on to building and deploying your devices, apps, and services. Here, there are a number of benefits of the modern management approach, from being able to securely connect to more device types and apps from just about anywhere, management from always up-to-date cloud-based services. And what all this means is that there's less infrastructure to manage. Now, you'll need Azure Active Directory running in advance. And remember that if you have any Office 365 services running now, you'll already have Azure AD. You can use System Center Configuration Manager alongside Microsoft Intune with co-management in order to manage these devices. And you can configure Office 365 Pro Plus apps along with your Windows 10 installation files. Now, there are two primary scenarios for moving your devices to Microsoft 365. For existing devices that were marked ready using Windows Analytics Upgrade Readiness, you can build task sequences that trigger instant upgrades, switch from BIOS to UEFI, and upgrade apps as required. For new devices, you can use Windows Autopilot Deployment and Microsoft Intune. Now, with Windows Autopilot Deployment Service, the initial setup experience when users receive a new device streamlines the out-of-box setup, signs you in with your organizational ID and Windows 10, can then automatically enroll into Intune and get customized with required apps and settings. So that was building and deploying your Microsoft 365 powered devices, which now brings us to the operate phase. Now there are a few things here of note. First, we've aligned the servicing models for Office 365 Pro Plus and Windows 10, and we deliver regular updates to Configuration Manager throughout the year. Secondly, you can continue to use Windows Analytics for update compliance and upgrade readiness and your device health as you manage your devices. Lastly, I recommend that you explore the options for management, productivity, and protection controls in the Enterprise Mobility Plus Security Suite within the Azure portal with capabilities like conditional access. So that was a quick summary of the things that you need to know and how to get started when deploying and managing Microsoft 365 powered devices. Be sure to check out the Microsoft 365 powered device playlist on Microsoft Mechanics to learn more about the topics I've covered today. Just about every tool and process I've shown here was explained in depth on the show. And I encourage you to make the most of your deeper hands-on training at the link below. I also hope that you enjoy experiencing these tools for yourself. Thanks for watching.